Hey, what's up everybody, it's your Boran here, so today I'll be doing Where the Deku Was Abandoned Part 12, I think, so let's begin. So, as a quick notice, I'm sorry for not being able to upload for probably 3 weeks or a month right now. I've been busy, you know, studying for the upcoming exams, and it's literally 1 week away. So after all, like, I finish my exams, I'll probably start going up going back to uploading slowly until I can upload daily. With no longer ado, let's begin. So in Izuku point of view, I open my eyes and see a white ceiling, and I try to get up, but I can't look down to see my two girlfriends on top of me. Katsumi on my right and Momo on my left. I nudge them a little bit for them to wake up. Izuku then said, "Momo, Katsumi, time to wake up." Katsumi then said, "5 more minutes, please." Momo then said, we are too comfortable to get up." Izuku then said, "The principal and Aizawa are coming this way." As they stood up and fixed their messy clothes and sat on a chair, Izuku sat on the bed and stretched her, like, his body, and so he wasn't wearing a shirt, and his two girlfriends, like, drool at his, like, body, and she's still packed. Okay, so Izuku then said, "Where is my costume?" Momo then said, "It was torn to shreds." Katsumi then said, "The principal sent it back to get fixed, or, like, and it need, like, fabric to come, and it's stronger than anything else." Izuku then said, I'm aware. As Aizawa and Nezu came in and saw that Izuku is awake, Nezu then said, "How are you feeling?" Izuku then said, "I feel great, sir, but a bit sore." Aizawa then said, "And that's good to hear, Izuku. So, we interrogated the villains that you told Todoroki to encase in an ice 2 questions. Izuku then said, "What did he said?" Aizawa then said that the bird monster is called a Nomu, and it was once a human. It had 3 quirks. Izuku then said, "3 quirks? That's impossible. Can someone force like to gain new quirks?" Then Nezu then said, "So you're alive, or like all for one?" Aizawa then said, "The quirks are hyper-regeneration, shock observation, shock absorption, and enhancement quirk." Nezu then said, "Also, I want to talk to you about the one called Tomura Shigaraki." Izuku said, "What do you want to know?" Nezu then said, "Your opinion about him." Izuku said, "Well, he seemed to be a bit child with a man body. When things don't go like the way he always brags about, that no more thing that will kill All Might. Like a kid getting a new toy for his birthday, he threw a tantrum when I killed his, like, precious Nomu." Nezu then said, "So a man child basically." Izuku then said, "Yes, but there is something else." Aizawa then said, "What's that?" Izuku then said, "I think he's not the true leader of the League of Villains, more like he is an apprentice given the key to the group. I think someone is working on the shadow, grooming him to be perfect soldier or something. Also, the Kurigiri person seem to have an agenda. Maybe the true leader is someone else, and ask Kurigiri to personally watch over Shigaraki." Nezu then said, "I see, thank you, Lucius. Also, since it's like Wednesday, you will have school until Monday. We are going to update the security of the school so this doesn't happen again." Izuku then said, "Sir, make sure to put scanners on the places where teacher held the most secure document." Nezu then said, "I never thought of that. I'll do it. Also, I want to thank you for saving the students and my 3 staff members. Izuku then said, "No, sir, it's what a hero does." So Aizawa smirks and then said, "Well said, Izuku." Izuku then said, thanks, uncle." Aizawa then replied, saying, "It's sensei at school, but I will let it slide this time. You and Katsumi and Yuruzu head home." Izuku then said, "Yes, sir." Momo then said, "Actually, Izuku, I was wondering if I can stay with you and Katsumi, since I'm still a little bit worried about you." Izuku then said, "Sure, I don't mind. And you, Katsumi?" Katsumi then said, "Fine by me." As all of them left, Aizawa couldn't help but chuckle at the sight of his, like, nephew having 2 girlfriends, since polygamy have been taken off from the laws of society since quirks appear. As the trio went to wore their regalia, they hopped in. Izuku drove with the top on because it started to rain. As they reached the house, they rushed inside to not get wet. As they got inside, Izuku got there like three towels, one for him and two for his girlfriend. Izuku then said, here you two. Tatsumi and Momo said, thank you. Izuku then said, so, you two want to hang out tomorrow since we don't have school until Monday? Tatsumi then said, sure. Momo then said, I would love to. Izuku replied saying, great. Hey, what do you want for dinner? Tatsumi and Momo said at the same time, anything is fine. Izuku then said, curry it is. As Izuku went to the kitchen, Katsumi and Momo talked. Katsumi said, Momo, you are sleeping with us tonight. Momo blushing then said, I can't. Katsumi then said, it's okay, Momo. It's a pretty big bed and you can cuddle with Izuku. I know you want to. Momo blushing then said, I do, but it's too soon. Katsumi then said, well, after he confessed his feeling to me, I slept with him in the same bed, mostly naked, and he does know how to care for your body. Momo blushed and then said, really? Katsumi then said, yes. I don't know how he does it, but he knows my sensitive spots that puts me over. So Momo then said, well, I got to find out. So how do you sleep with his, what do you wear? Katsumi then said, actually, I have plan for the both of us. Momo then said, what? Katsumi said, actually, I have two dress shirts of Ichan. I always wear one to sleep and with my, underwear only. I suggest that both of us sleep like that. Momo blushing then said, I can't. Katsumi then said, trust me, it would work and Ichan would have his mouth open too to see beautiful girls like that. It's every man's dream to see their girlfriend wearing their shirts and only their underwear. And about to say something like, it's facts, it's every man's dream. Like, be honest. So Momo then said, all right, let's do it. Izuku then said, dinner, you two. As they went to eat dinner, they had small conversation about what anything that came to mind. As they finished their dinner, Izuku picked up the plates and placed them on a dishwasher. Izuku then said, you two can go take a bath. I will take one after you two. Momo then said, thanks, Izuku. And Katsumi then said, let's go, Momo. Time skip. Izuku is laying on the bed when he heard the door open. He immediately blushed at the sight of his wife and girlfriend. They are wearing nothing but a white dress shirt of his and no bottoms. And they were only wearing their panties. He sees the guy like that Katsumi is wearing green and Momo red one. Izuku blushing said, you two, why are you dressing like that? Momo blushing said, well, since I don't want to sleep alone, Katsumi told me I could sleep with you. Katsumi then said, Ichan, we were both scared when we saw you like that, so I want you to comfort us by cuddling and snuggling when sleeping. Izuku then said, okay, come here, you two. As Katsumi took the right side and Izuku and Momo the left, they lay their heads down like on his chest. He wrapped his arm around them to bring them closer. He kissed their foreheads and the girl just dug deeper into his chest. Izuku then said, good night you two. Momo then said, good night, Izuku. Katsumi said also, good night, Ichan, Momo, as they fell asleep peacefully with care in the world. Now, the next day, Izuku woke up in the 5 in the morning, and since they have no school until Monday, he decided to go for a run. As he got up and without trying to take up the girls and changed into running clothes and his phone and headphones, he left a note saying he went out for a run. As he closed the door, he went jogging. He was running until something crashed into him and he looked down to see a scared white-haired little girl and she's crying. He bent down and placed his hand on her shoulder and said, what's the matter, little girl? Then the girl said, help me. Izuku then said, who is trying to hurt you? What is your name? The little girl said, Iri. Izuku then said, Iri, who is trying to hurt you? Iri then said, we hear a random person saying, Iri, don't bother the young man. Izuku sees Iri tense up and he sees the person is, and he recognizes him as the leader of the Yakuza overhaul. Izuku picked up Iri and has like flashbang grenade ready behind his back and his tendril creeping. Izuku then said, "Excuse me, sir, is this your daughter?" Then the unknown person said, "Yes. I'm sorry, she wanted an ice cream, but it will ruin her breakfast. I'm sorry for the inconveniences." Izuku then said, "I understand, but why is she covered in bandages? Maybe we might need to take her to the hospital." Then the person said, "No need, young man. She's accident prone. Please give her to me." Izuku then said, "Seriously, Overhaul? I'm not falling for your antics." Overhaul then said, "I see, so you know who I am. Give the girl and I will let you live, barely." Izuku then said, "Hang on, Iri." Izuku activated his kagune and sent them to Overhaul and pierced his body. Then tendrils sent grabbing him and threw him far away. Izuku like take the chance to run away as far from home, but he is close to UA, another part of town. Overhaul is seen crashing down in an alleyway near dumpsters. Overhaul said, "That boy, he took my cure. I swear I will get it back and I will kill the kid no matter what. But why I'm not healing? He's strange. And that power, I couldn't take it, took it." As Overhaul called his team to help him, he was pissed by this guy. Back to Izuku and Iri. They are running and they reach UA, where Inko and Nizu, All Might and Aizawa, who is bandaged to see Izuku running while holding little girl. Aizawa then said, "Izuku, why do you have the girl with you and why are you out of breath?" Izuku then said, "I called Shota, I ran into Overhaul, the leader of the 8 precepts, and he had this girl with him, and she was scared, so I had no choice but to fight and just send him flying, and I ran toward UA." Nizu then said, "I see, Lucius, let's go inside." Inko then said, "Izuku, are you alright? Without realizing, he called her a name she wanted to hear for a long time. Izuku then said, "Yes, ma'am, I'm fine." As he walked inside with Izuku and Aizawa, without realizing what he just said, Inko was crying tears of happiness. So Inko, crying like in tears, said, "He called me mom." Then All Might smiles and said, "Well, I'm happy for you, Aizawa. You might be the first to forgive." Inko then said, "What about you, Toshi?" All Might then said, "The important thing that he forgave you. I will wait until I earn my son's forgiveness, no matter how many years it will take." Inko then said, "Toshi, you are hurting because you like remind yourself of you and your father and vow to be better men, but you turned out like him and you hate yourself." As they catch up to them, Inko saw the little girl didn't stop holding Izuku. She saw it like her life depend on it. As they reach like the recovery girl office, and RG was there writing her reports when she saw them enter. RG then said, "Lucius, you broke something again?" Izuku then said, "No, not exactly. Can you check up on this little girl?" Then RG said, "Okay, sit her down." Izuku tries to sit her down on the bed, but she won't budge. Iri crying then said, "Don't leave me." Nizu then said, "Lucius, stay with her after the checkups. You can come to my office. We'll be there waiting." Izuku then said, "Yes, sir." "Iri, don't worry. I will be here. But you're gonna let RG look at you to make sure you are healthy." Iri then said, "She won't hurt me?" Izuku then said, "No. She just wants to check you if you are okay." Iri then said, "Okay." As Izuku sat down and RG was smiling on how Iri is with Izuku, she immediately checked her temperature, her eyes, ears. She checked everything and she was happy that she was healthy, but she missed some of her vitamins. RG then said, "Can I check your arms, Iri?" Izuku then said, "It's okay, Iri. She wants to check your arms." Iri then said, "Okay." Izuku took off the bandages, was shocked to the two how many scars she have, and they are not even healed properly. Izuku saw Iri was crying seeing her scars when he pulled his sleeve to let Iri see his scars from training. Izuku then said, "Iri, look." As Iri saw Izuku's arm with the scars and she touched them and tears crept out her eyes, Izuku just patted her head and smiled at her. Izuku then said, "Iri, Scars aren't bad, they just mean you survived. Yuri crying and she hugged him and he hugged her back while RG spoke. RG then said, Lucius, you look like a dad comforting his little girl. Izuku blushed and said, me, a dad. Yuri then said, that mean you are my daddy? Izuku then said, do you want me to be your daddy? Yuri then said, yes. Izuku, of course, I will be your daddy. Yuri then said, yes, daddy, I love you. You know, the type of like innocent kid who love their parents. Izuku then said, I love you too. How am I going to explain this to Katsumi and Momo? RG then said, I'm done, Lucius. You can go and talk to Nizu. Izuku then said, yes, ma'am. Thank you. As Azawa, as Izuku left with Iri, RG was happy that Izuku was happy. No thanks to his father, RG is going to scold Toshinori on being bad dad toward his son. As Izuku and Iri goes toward Nizu office, received a phone call from Katsumi to check up. He had missed 10 calls from her. He answered phone call. Katsumi Ichan, said, Ichan, where are you? I've been calling you about... but you didn't answer me, and me and Momo are worried. Then Izuku said, I'm fine. Can you two come to UA? Katsumi then said, why? Izuku then said, I ran into a villain. I had to flee and save someone, and I'm going to talk to the principal about what is next. Katsumi then said, are you alright? Izuku then said, yeah, I just threw him far away and I ran. Izuku, Katsumi then said, okay, we'll be there shortly. Izuku then said, okay, bye. Katsumi then said, bye, and the phone call ended. Izuku then said, looked at Iri and she was confused. Iri then said, who was that, daddy? Izuku then said, my wife. Iri then said, is she my mommy? Izuku then said, yeah, she is picking us up after we talked to the principal. Then Iri said, okay, dad. As they reached the office and knocked on the door, guys, about me started a lot in this video. So Nizu then said, come in. As the dad and daughter went in there to surprise to see teacher, a guy with glasses and a third year classmate. Izuku then said, hello. Nizu then said, hello, this is Sir Naitai and Mirio Tugata, the one in charge of overhaul case. Naitai then said, Izuku Yage. Yeah, Izuku then said, it's Izuku Lucius, call him sir. Naitai then said, okay, I was wondering, can you speak with Iri? Then Izuku said, before that, Nizu sir, I was wondering, can I adopt Iri since she is attached to me? Nizu then said, actually, I already drawn the paper, only you and your wife have to sign, and she's officially yours. Izuku then said, thank you. Thanks, Sir Naitai. You can speak with her, but I doubt she will say anything. Mirio then said, hey, Iri, my name is Mirio Tugata. Nice to meet you. Then Iri said, hi, Mr. Tugata. Mirio then said, you can call me Mirio. Iri then said, okay. Naitai said, Iri, I was wondering, why were you with Overhaul? Iri started to cry, but Izuku just comforted her and she calmed down a bit. Iri then said, Iri, it's fine to answer. You will not get into trouble. Iri crying said, he poked my arms and drew blood from them. To create an erasing bullet, he told me I was a curse. I don't deserve to be a human. Izuku then said, Iri, you are not a curse in this world. You are Iri Lucius Kalium. Whatever your quirk is, not a curse is a precious gift. Iri just hugged her like daddy and cries. And the adults, Mirio, are pissed at Overhaul and plans to investigate. Naitai then said, thank you, Iri, for sharing Lucius. Want to be on the raid? Izuku then said, of course, when? Naitai then said, a couple of months, we need to gather evidence because judge will not believe a little girl's words. Izuku then said, I understand. Naitai then said, you and Mirio will be the one to take care of her and he will help you on protecting her when you are busy. Izuku then said, Tugata senpai, I look forward working with you. Tugata then said, I can ask you something, Lucius? Then Izuku said, yeah, sure. Mirio smiles then said, what kind of hero you want to be? Izuku smiled then said, a hero that brings smile to the people and be strong for people, not worried about me. Mirio then said, that's great answer. Izuku then saw he got a text and looked at Nizu. Izuku then said, sir, my ride is here. Can I leave? Nizu then said, sure, but I want the form signed by tomorrow. Izuku then said, Yes, sir. Miri already said, I will walk with you so we can work on how to protect this special, precious snowflake. Iri then said, can I call you Uncle Mirio? Mirio then said, sure. Izuku then said, thanks to Gata Senpa, call me Mirio said. Izuku said, okay Mirio, you can call me Izuku. As they left, Naitai looked at Omat and Enko. Naitai then said, you two disappoint me. How can you ignore your own child, especially you, All Might, if you were in the same boat as him? All Might crying then said, I know, Mira. I know I was wrong to ignore him, and I don't blame him not seeing me as a father. Inko crying then said, me too. He didn't even saw us, see us, as he just focused on you at Nizu. Nizu then said, he sure loves the little girl. Naitai then said, that boy is something else. I hope they are ready to meet the monster inside him. Naitai remember using his curtain at him and see him crying out, and his hair is completely white. He is being tortured by men in a black suit. With that, I'm gonna end this cliffhanger as usual. I hope you enjoyed it, and yeah. So as I said before, I will start slowly getting back to uploading until I can upload regularly. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this. Stay home, stay safe, wash your hands, and spend the time with the most precious people you have. Don't like the video or subscribe until you like my content. And catch you in the next video. Peace out. Bye bye.